Hello everyone, this is Shivashankar Pandian. You are currently watching the 10th part video of our 100 plus idiom series. Let's get started. The first idiom is dark horse. It refers to someone whose ability is a mystery or unknown to others. Let's see an example. No one knew about her earlier, but suddenly she is being seen as the dark horse with such amazing abilities. This idiom has its origin in horse racing. People who are willing to bet select their horses by studying the lineage and previous achievements of the horses. If these information are not available, then there is no way to know the strength and weakness of this animal. So these animals are also known as dark horses, whose potential is unknown. The next idiom is second wind. It refers to the renewed energy you get when you are too tired. Let's see an example. Come on, let's climb further. I'm getting a second wind now. This idiom has its origin in physical activities like sports. For instance, marathon runners often get a second wind at some point in the race, after which they find it easier to breathe. The third idiom is go off the deep end. It refers to the act of giving way immediately to an emotional outburst, especially anger. Here's an example. Don't tell your wife that you lost all your money. She'll just go off the deep end. Here, deep end refers to the deep end of a swimming pool. What will a person do who don't know swimming is thrown into the deep end? He'll definitely get agitated and surely be angry on the guy who threw him. The next idiom of this video is who pays the piper calls the tune. It means that the person who pays for something will or should dictate how something should be done. Here's an example. When Linda told the artist what she wanted her portrait to look like, the artist felt that she had a bad taste. Still, he who pays the piper calls the tune, and Linda got what she wanted. A piper is a musician who plays a pipe. The person who hires them can choose the songs what they play. The next one is sweep under the rug. It means to try to hide a problem or keep a problem a secret instead of dealing with it. Let's see an example. There are many problematic realities that we sweep under the rug, one of them being domestic violence. This idiom is born out of the idea of a maid or a homekeeper lazily sweeping the dirt under the rug or a mat rather than going through the work to actually clean up the dust. Even we do this at times. The next idiom is bury the hatchet. It means to make peace with an individual by resolving all differences. Here's an example. India and Pakistan should work on an agreement to bury the hatchet in order to avoid escalation of conflicts. The idiom has its origin in America. A hatchet is nothing but an axe used by Native Americans. When these Native Americans wanted to make peace, they buried a hatchet as a symbolic way of saying that our old differences are now buried. The next one is zero hour. It refers to a time when a crucial decision must be taken. Let's see an example. Parliament passed many important bills during today's zero hour. Zero hour is an English translation of a German word. Zero hour is used to mark the end of the Second World War. Another theory suggests that the idiom's origin is related to military, because most ambush attacks were made at midnight without letting the enemy know. The next idiom is know on which side one's bread is buttered. It means to know what is to one's advantage or be aware of where one's interests lie. For example, he gave his boss a gift last week because he knows which side his bread is buttered. The next idiom is storm in a teacup. Americans call it tempest in a teapot. Both has the same context. It means an excessive enthusiasm or rage about an insignificant matter. For example, eventually the police found out that the issue is nothing more than a storm in a teacup. A teacup is a small space. If there is a storm in it, it must be small too. And should we really worry about it? The last idiom of this video is skeleton in the closet. It refers to an act of embarrassing or a shameful secret that you don't want others to know it. For an example, our great-grandfather had been in prison for bank robbery. Our dad thinks that it is a skeleton in our closet. This idiom has a horrible history. The UK Parliament passed a law in 1832 allowing doctors to dissect dead bodies for medical research. But before such law was made, many doctors used the corpses of executed criminals. They can't keep the dissected body in public. The most obvious place to hide was their closet. So tell me, if you have a skeleton in your closet, will you want others to find out? If you like this video, kindly subscribe to our channel. Use the bell icon to get notifications whenever we post a new video. Thanks for your time.